FM News. On point. Look at the news. The NRM Secretariat has blamed the Uganda Police Force for failing to implement the COVID-19 guidelines ahead of the 2021 general elections. The Ministry of Health suspended meetings of more than 200 people in a move to fight the spread of COVID-19 during the ongoing campaigns. Party Director Communications Emmanuel Dumbo says the COVID-19 SOPs have been abused by politicians, gathering thousands of people on their rallies as police looks on, saying the police must take on its role and implement the guidelines as directed by the Ministry of Health.
Unfortunately, there are many other leaders in the NRM and the candidates at the different levels who unfortunately breach the regulations. And at times they do this in conspiracy with the security organs or without the security organs knowing or being present. But to us, the only thing we can do is to appeal to the security organs who are mandated by law and facilitated by government to enable them to ensure that people don't break the law, that they should go ahead and do that.
Dumbo tasked police to publicly explain their hindrances when it comes to implementation of COVID-19 guidelines because the NRM government is ready to avail them with the necessary support.
President Yoweri Museveni, amongst the candidates, is the one who complies almost 101% with the COVID regulation. He tries as much as possible to address meetings that are less than 200 people. In the circumstances that they have failed, they must tell the country why. Is it an issue of resources? Is it an issue of manpower? Or is that an issue of them not knowing?
Lord Mayor aspirant Kampala Nabila Nagai Sempala has warned the public against being complacent in observing COVID-19 SOPs. Nabila says since COVID-19 is at a deadly stage and it should be the responsibility of every person to take action since most of the hospitals are overwhelmed by the number of patients.
If we observe the standards and the SOPs that have been given to us, wash your hands, put on masks, have a heart of protecting those around you, and also avoid huge gatherings, especially that are unnecessary. I want also to tell people that COVID is manageable. Personally, I'm a survivor of COVID. I had COVID, but it is, you can heal from it. So I don't want people to get scared that it's a death trap. And I think that's a wrong mindset too, to tell people that COVID is not curable. I think let's change that. We need to avoid it, prevent it, but we don't need to think about COVID as a death trap. Otherwise, we'll create a monster out of it.
Civil Aviation Authority has limited the number of guests to a maximum of two people to accompany or pick a traveler from Entebbe International Airport. The Director of Communications, Civil Aviation Authority, Vianney Iluja, says since the spread of COVID-19 is at a very high rate, the number of people at the airport has been limited to avoid congestion, which can increase the risk of contracting COVID-19. Iluja has also asked travelers to move with COVID-19 negative results because they will not be allowed to access the airport without it.
We are therefore requesting and urging the public to ensure that if you are picking up someone, you should at most be two people in a vehicle, and that includes the driver and one relative to the person. And it applies both to those picking, those returning, as well as those escorting passengers. The other thing is we are reminding passengers of the SOPs in relation to PCR COVID-19 tests, where we are saying that on departure, while Uganda indicates 120 hours from the time of sample collection to the time of the flight's departure, when the destination country has indicated a specific number of hours that may be less than the 120 that we have indicated, those take priority.
In sports news, Uganda Cranes home base players start training today ahead of the African Nations tournament that starts next month in Cameroon. A provisional team of 28 players was summoned by head coach Jonathan McKinstry over the weekend for a tournament that starts 17th January to 16th February. The provisional squad has rookies to the national team set up as Police's Mohamed Hassan, Uganda under 20 trio of Aziz Kayondo, Ivan Bogelian, Bobos Biaruhanga, as well as Bulls on form forward Joseph Semuju. KCCA players that traveled to Rwanda for the CAF Confederations Cup game against AS Kigali are not part of the Cranes squad, but McKinstry says other players will be given an opportunity.
ultimately it is neither FUFA nor KCCA's fault that the games, that there is a run over and a clash. It's just the way the scheduling has been put together by CAF at the top end, and it's a challenge that we have to deal with and overcome. But in those players joining us later, those players from KCCA will be selected at the beginning of January, but it gives ultimately other players a chance in this early phase.
In other news this morning, Sudan and Ethiopia will hold negotiations next week to delineate their shared border. A statement from Sudanese Prime Minister Abdallah Hamdok's office said the talks will be held Tuesday, a week after Ethiopian forces reportedly ambushed and killed Sudanese troops along the border. The two leaders met on the margins of a summit underway on Sunday in Djibouti over the Intergovernmental Authority on Development in East African Regional Bloc, comprising 8 countries. Hamdok is the current head of IGAD. A cross-border attack by Ethiopian forces and rebels last Tuesday killed at least 4 Sudanese troops and wounded a dozen others in the Abu Tair area in eastern Sudan's Gadarif province. Sudan's state-run news agency said its military had deployed large reinforcements into the province to reclaim territories controlled by Ethiopian farmers and rebels in Sudan's Al-Fash border area. The troops would stop at the borderline, according to the 1902 deals between Sudan and Ethiopia. Tuesday's cross-border attack in Abu Tair came amid weeks-long fighting in Ethiopia's northern Tigray region that has pitted the federal government against region authorities. Now, the Tigray fighting has sent more than 52,000 Ethiopian refugees into Sudan, most of them in Gadarif province. At the start of the clashes in Tigray, Sudan deployed more than 6,000 soldiers to its border with Ethiopia. In entertainment news, Ariana Grande announced that she is engaged to Dalton Gomez. On Sunday, the 27-year-old pop star shared a photo of a stunning diamond ring on her left finger as she wrote "Forever and Then Some," along with some loved-up snaps. The engagement comes just after nearly a year of dating her real estate boyfriend. Posting 4 photos to commemorate the joyous announcement, Grande shared images of the couple along with a close-up photo of her giant sparkler. The pair were first linked back in January 2020 and have continued to go from strength to strength, as evident with the proposal. Now, a source from Grande's camp said they could not be happier. They're just so excited. This is a happy time for them. Both sets of parents are thrilled. That was the news.
XFM News on point.